Previously on Travel Stories, I attended an Indian wedding that I was invited to in a cab by a complete stranger. On this episode, I share stories from my first month ever in India.
So, my friends.
What?
This is part two. Uh-huh. This is the second time we've been doing these videos. Mm-hmm. And in the last video, I was just leaving the wedding mm-hmm. and going in the car to New Delhi. Huh. Yeah?
Yes.
So, shall we continue on this trip?
Yes.
So, like I was saying, this is a video in the car ride going back to Delhi mm-hmm. after the wedding. So in my third day in India, and my plan was to go like meditate in like the yoga center for 2 weeks.
Oh, you told me before.
Yeah, and this plan like instantly just got thrown away. Mm-hmm. So now I was thinking like, okay, now what do I do? Mm-hmm. And the family members from the wedding were taking me to the airport because of a long story. You know, before I hurt my knee like so many times, I had a lot of surgeries on my knee. Mm-hmm. And through somebody I knew in America, they told me there's like a doctor in India who's like specialty for doing like good massages mm-hmm. to like help your body recover. Mm-hmm. So I knew he lived in one city called Pune, and I had his like phone number and his email. Mm-hmm. So now that I'm leaving the wedding, they're driving me to their home. They're going to their home in Delhi. Mm-hmm. But they said, okay, we'll just take you to the airport. Mm-hmm. So like my plan is I'm gonna go to the airport. I don't have a ticket. Mm-hmm. The people in the city Pune know I'm gonna come, but they don't know I'm coming now. So like I'm completely like just doing things now. Mm. So like you can barely see here, but there's some traffic, and this is like after 7 hours of driving, we're finally getting to Delhi.
Oh my god, 7 hours.
Yeah.
I feel living but in the car. Mm.
Dharamshala. Yeah, that one was worse. Mm-hmm. This one was much easier, thankfully. So I got to the airport in Delhi, and like quickly I bought a ticket to the city Pune. Mm-hmm. And actually, sorry, no. I had to buy a ticket to Mumbai. Mm-hmm. So I flew to Mumbai like 1 hour after I got to the airport. Mm-hmm. And then I got there maybe like 10 at night. Mm-hmm. And I had to sleep there because there was nowhere I could go. So I slept in the airport like all night. I woke up in the morning and I got in a taxi. As I said, I have to go in the bus station so I can take a bus to Pune. Because mm-hmm. in this city, I'm hoping I can find the person to do the massages mm-hmm. and do some yoga. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I want to go traveling also. Yeah, this was a good camera.
I look at the camera now. I feel somebody look at me.
Hopefully people do look. So this is Mumbai. This is like one of the biggest cities.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
The boring was it a long time.
I don't remember being bored. I was speaking to the two guys in the taxi, mm-hmm. but they like tried doing some scam. They wanted to like switch money with me or something. Mm-hmm. And I'm not quite sure what they were trying to do. No, I wasn't lonely. Today? Oh, come to India? So this is still in Mumbai.
Oh, February 11th, I go to Thailand.
I hear.
Yeah, I was telling the guy I'm gonna be going to Thailand in a month from now, basically.
Why the color? Like, is it sky or is it sun?
Yeah, it's got like orange gradient in the sky.
Is it a night top?
No, this is early morning. It's maybe 6 in the morning, 7 in the morning.
You see, on the lot, like, we can see not so much dirty.
Oh, trash. So much trash just like littered everywhere. It looks like smoke. We just drove by a bunch of smoke.
Yeah, I remember this too. Everywhere has smoke.
Yeah, so much trash. It looks so crazy. It always stands out to me. It always stands out to me how many people walk on the streets in India because they don't have sidewalks.
Mm-hmm.
Not the same way that we do.
But I really love it, the rickshaw.
Yeah, the rickshaw is fun.
For me, it looks like a Meet the Bean car.
Mr. Beans. This is the taxi that was taking me. I tell you, there's two guys and they somehow want to take my money. I don't know exactly what they were trying to do. I think they say, like, give us 100 and we'll give you Indian money, but, like, they weren't trying to do it fair.
Mm.
They wanted to cheat me.
And what you do?
I said, no problem. Looks like you're going to hit the car there. So once I finally did get to the train station or the bus station, it's like a 2-hour bus ride to get to Pune. This is on the west coast of India, so it's like opposite of Calcutta. Looks so pretty, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
This is not make feel like India.
Yeah. Not from what we saw. Mm-hmm. This doesn't look like the India we saw. India is such a big country. It's got like, it has everything.
Mm-hmm.
Jungles to like snow and mountains, and I think this video is when I'm finally arriving to Pune. Yeah, so I'm still in the bus, and this is like maybe my first time seeing a Hindu temple.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see out the window, and like we're about to like finish.
Mm-hmm.
And get into the city, like at the actual bus stop.
I can't remember the video or the final.
To be honest, I don't remember. I just clicked this one to see what it is, and so far this looks pretty boring. So I'll close that one. But I've seen these videos like so many times. Oh, okay. You can see it already looks different from Mumbai. This is a pretty big city too. It's not like one of the biggest cities in India, like Delhi or Mumbai or Calcutta. It's a big city though. Got a lot of universities, I think, also. So next video, we're on the auto rickshaw.
Oh my gosh, Jersey.
You can see here by the mouse, this is the meter. It tells you how much.
Uh-huh.
But I didn't learn yet that this is the meter, so I would like speak to me like, I need a hotel, how much? I had no idea where I'm going. I just told this guy, I need a hotel. He'll like take me a place and I'll tell him like, no, it's too expensive. Another place.
This is working like an athlete.
You see all these Muslim guys?
Mm-hmm.
I love this video. It looks so cool being in the rickshaw. Being in the rickshaw is so fun.
Oh, me turn I am.
That's when I was younger. Wow, that's a long video. Let me skip ahead and see if there's anything interesting. I think I get to a red light and there's like someone funny next to me or something. I hear him at the red light. It doesn't look like anything. Right now? Yeah, that's all. Someone walks by, wow. So, I somehow lost the videos from like the doctor who gave me the massages, and it was like such a dark room with like no windows, and there's one like light hanging from the ceiling.
Oh,
it was like dirty. I felt like, what the fuck? This isn't a doctor's place like in America. And the first day he went to massage me, he was just getting ready and he's like,
oh, you tell me.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
It was weird. Like, the massage actually helped a lot, but I don't need to get into it. Maybe another time. Weird stuff.
You want a shot?
Yeah, I'll give it a try. Oops. I guess this is the video I'm looking for. So I got set up with this lady. She was a yoga teacher.
And this is your cat?
Yeah.
Oh, so very good to play your cat.
Yeah, we went out into the, like, the mountains outside of the city.
How did that go on? From class?
Too much. This lady, like, was a nice lady, but she was cheating me. She was making me pay so much money compared to her Indian students. So when I found this out, I told her, I'm like, goodbye. And I went and I got a really nice yoga teacher, just one-on-one.
So many students?
Right now, it's just me, her husband, her daughter, and a student from another country who, like, was in high school and switched countries.
Why aren't I happy?
Thank you. It's Valentine's Day now, by the way. She was actually a good yoga teacher. Like, I would have been happy to stay with her. But she was cheating me.
Like what? One of the kids money you a lot.
Yeah, like, if the normal people pay, like, 50, she was making me pay, like, 200 or something like that.
No more because you're like drunk.
Yeah, but that's not fair. I think in the next video, I do a little yoga.
And now she show.
Hmm.
Now she show. Everybody look at she show.
Yoga. Yeah. She wanted to make a video for her.
Mhm. For me, look boring.
Mm-hmm. Heavy. Look at this. This is boring too. Yeah.
No, I mean she.
Oh. I think the same.
Uh-oh, then.
Oh. Anyway,
what?
So I lived in this city for like a month, like for 4 weeks maybe, something like that. Every day I like get a massage and do yoga one-on-one with a different teacher.
I even have a video of that.
No, I lost it somehow.
Mm-hmm.
But I tell you one cool story if I can find the picture right now. Here we go. So I was staying at a hotel, and I was, like, super lonely. Like, this was the loneliest month of my life.
Mm-hmm.
And for, like, the first week, I was staying at a hotel,
uh-huh.
And one day, I met two English people
mm-hmm.
that were, like, pastors. Like, not monks. This is, like, the person who teaches you about Christianity and Jesus and stuff. Mm-hmm. So I was so happy to speak with them because I was lonely, and they told me they came to they came because they wanted to teach people about Christianity, and there was one group of people who you're seeing now
mm-hmm.
that they, like, for some reason people didn't look after them in the city, like, they were low in the city, I don't know why
mm-hmm.
and they worked with camels
mm-hmm.
So he said, hey, I'm gonna go speak to them and teach them about Jesus, you want to come?
Mm-hmm.
And you already know I don't believe in that stuff, but I said, sure, I'll come. And that's how this picture got taken.
Just that, yeah.
Yeah, but it was crazy.
Because
he taught for like 1 hour, and after that,
mm-hmm.
they do this thing in Christianity where, like, if you have something bad, you can go to the man and he does like this to you.
Oh,
yeah, I showed you the video, and a lady did the same thing. One lady got, like, possessed by, like, the spirit, they call it, and she started, like, me and this guy were, like, freaking out, like, what the fuck's going on? Because, like, We were in a little room that was made out of rugs. Mm-hmm. Like, it wasn't a house. It was made out of carpet.
Mm-hmm.
Or rugs, really. And the sun had gone down, so now it's nighttime, and we're, like, in a whole new environment, like, place we've never been before. And, like, this lady's, like, going crazy, like she has a ghost inside her. And then me and him were, like, freaked out, but then, like, one of the Indian guys, who's also a Christian pastor, just started telling the lady, like, stop! Ah! Like, giving, like, power like this to her. And then they're like, yeah, she's a little crazy. So then we rode the camels.
Are you laughing?
Afterwards, I had video of that too. I somehow lost it over the years. So I had fun with them. Anyway, this is still in the city of Pune.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if I can show you a little bit about the city. To rewind to yesterday's episode, we're back at the wedding now.
Mm-hmm.
There's the bride, who we didn't get to see much of in the first video. The husband looking so freaking cool. My favorite guy.
Mm-hmm.
Grandpa right here, so cool.
I'm gonna have high like it. Remember we go, Grandpa said. Everyone
yeah.
like his land.
Yeah. Look how
so cute.
I thought this was a girl. This is a boy, but he's so freaking cute. Yeah, because he has this, so that's a boy. He has that on his head, a turban. These are some of the guys who are working here. Like, this guy, I don't think he's Indian. I think he's from, like, Nepal. Maybe him too. Whoops. My drinking buddies, some food. The husband started dressing Western style.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, hey.
Look at eyes.
Yeah, she had blue eyes.
Mm-hmm.
And real, I think. Maybe not. I don't know.
I don't know.
I think they're real. This guy, what do you think his face is saying?
Nepal.
Well, what do you think he feels?
Happy.
Really?
Why he looks sad?
For me, he looks happy, sad. Because I spoke to him. And I think he felt like a person who's a low person is not supposed to speak with me.
Mm-hmm.
So I think, and when I see this picture from my memory, when I spoke to him, he felt so happy that I treated him like equal, like we're the same.
Mm-hmm.
But I also see someone who looks like ready to cry.
Because in India, people have to see. Below
hmm.
like this.
Yeah, like for instance, at the wedding there was no trash bins. If you were eating something you finished, you go like this.
Really? What the fuck? I can go like, what's doing?
And that's how their style is. And like his job was, he was one of the people, like there was people to give you your food, there's people to pick stuff off the ground.
So bad.
So I'm saying, I think in his life he's a low person.
Oh my God.
So I see someone happy, sad. I see someone who's ready to cry.
Oh my God.
Alright, that's how I see it. Oh, cool looking guy.
Look at this.
Uh-huh.
You see?
Mm-hmm.
These are people eating.
Yep. Just throw it on the ground.
It's so bad.
Saw me dancing with this guy in the video. These guys look too fucking cool. So, here's actually in Pune. So now we're back to Pune, and this is a little outside the city. We were coming home from the yoga on the mountain. He stopped by his temple, and one day I went to relax, and I leaned against something. I leaned against the statue of a cow, and I forgot this is like God in India. So I felt so bad. The person's like, no, don't sit there. So for you, this is normal, right? For me, this was the first time I've ever seen a market like this. Because I'm telling you, maybe some places in America, in the country, there's markets like this. But where I'm from, you see, there's a kid under here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But this was the first time I've ever seen something like this. So this picture and this memory like sticks with me a lot. Because this is like very interesting to see.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, my first week or so, I was in a hotel. A YMCA hotel, and I met this guy. Then I had my own apartment for a few weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And this picture was important to me because this is the swastika And for you, this is normal. This is like something for good luck. But for us in America, we see this. Ah, thank you. For us, this is like something from Nazi Germany. So this is, when I grew up, this is bad. But now I know in Asia, this is good.
Mm.
So seeing an animal eat trash, normal, right? These people inside here were making alcohol. So my apartment wasn't far from here. And one day I'm walking and someone like, hey, come here. And they called me inside.
What?
I'll have to come back to show that. This is a barber.
Oh.
This is on the road. There's a barber right here and someone's getting a shave.
Missing.
Right on the side of the road. Yeah. All right. So these are the people. One of them is like, this is the place where they called me to come inside.
You look like a, you know, Doraemon.
This one?
No, he doesn't say Doraemon. He says Giant. Giant in Doraemon. The big man, he likes boxing in Nobita.
For me, this looks like a bad person.
Yes.
So, they were making alcohol, and this was like a bad place, so... They gave me some alcohol made, it's like a beer, but from coconut.
Mm-hmm.
I'm speaking to all these people who were just drinking.
You look at your shirt. Me tell y'all. So cute. Me tell y'all.
Okay, so I'll come back to this picture, but this, after 10 minutes, somebody came to me, and he took me outside, he goes... The people here are bad men. Go now.
Oh,
so yeah. I said, okay, and I just left.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, this is good. Bali, you.
Yeah. So this sad picture is something we've both seen, and you see too much in India.
Mm-hmm. Look at this, have this lock.
Yeah, it's like dreadlocks. Yeah.
And what you feel when you see it?
Same as you. It's so sad and you see it too much and you don't know what to do always. I think the next picture shows another person. Oh no. Ah, somehow that was sad. Didn't have to get back. Roti.
I wanna take it.
Looks so good. I'd like to eat this also.
I remember.
So we'll come back to that later. Let's get back and see videos of Pune. I wonder if there's something wrong with this video. So this was like my first week. And this is only like 500 meters away from the hotel I was staying. I just wanted to show a video of what it looks like. You can see this guy came up and wanted to speak to me.
So cool. Like, come on. Hey, what's up?
Yeah.
Okay. What's up, man?
Money? What about it?
What
you already started asking about money. You know.
What are you doing?
You come like. Hey, what's up? Money.
Hey, you got money? Really?
What about it? What, you want money? You want money? I want money too. I want money.
I want money too. I like, I'm funny. Oh, I feel bad. I'm funny. It's bad too.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, you see he's not happy now. Like, Al knows this, I know this. If you haven't been into India, but you plan to go one day, something to know is like, Indians are some of the nicest people there are. But that's like a large percentage. But then there's a percentage who just act nice, but they're just trying to get your money. So they kind of fuck shit up for all the other nice people.
Oh,
know.
Baby?
I hope there's some like salad in there.
Look like the cow, okay? You cannot like everything but look at that life.
Oh, the cow's like free, but they don't have a good life?
Yeah.
Well, it's kind of like a lot of the people in India,
But you
right?
see a beach, I don't understand.
Yeah. One thing I did learn, sometimes the cows are free, but sometimes these are people's cows. Oh yeah, and this kid just came up to me and he just wanted to talk and like be my tour guide. So he just started walking me to somewhere. I think we like go to a market. Yeah, in here, inside here is a market, but outside I saw all these birds like
So many birds.
I think there must be some food at the market, like I don't know. As you can see probably in this video, yeah, in this video too. Just something I wanted looked interesting to my eyes, so I just wanted to capture
Oh,
it.
it's a thing for me too.
That's a longer video. Let's see what's this guy. It's like birds, birds, birds.
Oh my God, you see fighting.
Yeah, I saw that. So hopefully that's the end of the birds. This guy asked for some money. I think I gave him some money. This is the place that I showed you the picture of the roti. Up here is where they're cooking the roti. There you go. You see? So he's sitting down here. You can see his leg. The lighting's not so good, so you can't see it too well.
Oh, no. I have cookies.
So delicious, right?
I have cookies.
I got it. Close up, no? So there's your boyfriend before you knew him. What do you think? Had longer hair, curly hair.
You look so young.
Here I'm like 26, I think. I think I was 26 there. Oh shit! That's fast forwarding a few months, people. That's a little surprise of what to
Oh my
see
God. You fat little
later.
piggy doing that.
That was like how many months later? One. Three. That was like 4 months later. So, I still got some videos that I can show from India. Because for this video, we can finish for India. Or, let me see.
What is it?
That's Atika's house. Fuck.
So how you go in the Soyani Hall and I know
Children International.
Children International
Yeah.
and you'll get a pig guy, yeah?
No, before I only had one. Before I only had a Tika. So
On the
I'm,
website?
yeah. So I'll tell you what I was talking about, and then we'll come back to that. To finish my trip in Calcutta, I visited a child named Atika, who I sponsored through Children International, whose website is children.org. I'll come back to that in a second, but we'll just finish up the rest of India because that's how we finish India. This is all Calcutta, so I think there's only a couple videos I can show you. Monkey! I don't know what was down there. This is that one day that we went to do the yoga on the mountain. So going up,
Okay.
like in my dad's country, Saint Kitts, I've seen monkeys before, but this was like the second time I've seen monkeys. Ooh.
Lion, what are you doing, Lion? Come on. Lion,
Really?
come on, Lion. Lion.
And I wanted to get so close, but then the dad was like scared for me. They're saying the monkeys will like fight you and attack you. So that girl you just saw was the daughter of the yoga teacher. Right. So I spent like 1 weekend at the wedding, and I spent about 4 weeks in Pune doing yoga and the massage. And
And there's
last
that
week in
one
India,
too.
just flew to Calcutta just to
You see
visit
it?
Atika. So let's see.
I'm so food.
I guess I can fast forward and show this. Let me pause this. This is Children International. Our mission is to bring real and lasting change to children living in poverty. In partnership with contributors, we reduce their daily struggles, invest in their potential, and provide them with the opportunity to grow up healthy, educated, and prepared to succeed and contribute to society. So, I was...
Let me list.
Yeah?
Our mission is to bring light and lasting change to students living in poverty in partnership.
Partnership. You
partnership.
Can't see it.
With contributor, we loop then there is stuckers involved in the process and power them with the opportunity to go up hardy and educated and prepared to secret and contribute to security. For 10. How much you give me?
2.
Oh my god!
In 1 year, you're gonna watch this video and be like, I know in 1 year your English is gonna be so good that when you watch this video, you're gonna think like, wow, I did not know how to speak English.
So, show me.
Checked into a hotel in Calcutta. They sent someone to the hotel, same like when we did it,
mm-hmm.
and drove me to Children International. The same person, Raju.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be able to show you him in one of these videos. Here it is.
It's Friday morning. I'm here with Rajinder from Children International. We're on our way to the office building. From there, they're going to show me around, and then we're going to go be able to meet Atiqua. And right now, we're just dealing with some Calcutta traffic. Okay.
I thought her name was Atiqua. I didn't know it was Atika.
Mm-hmm.
Look how much trash. I need to stop this because people who lived in America have never seen something like this. I want people to know, like, this shit is real.
I don't understand. It's just for people come to take a traffic from here.
This is called a squatter. This means if you have no house, maybe you're from the village and you want to move to the city, where can you move in the city if you have no money? You just put something and you say, I live here. And maybe one day the government's going to come and tell everybody you have to go and they take down the houses.
Uh-huh.
And then the people have to go and find somewhere more.
Mm-hmm. And why is it so dirty? People do?
Because we
this
have...
Is the people for, this is the paid for people... Take a stowaway.
No. These people have no garbage.
Mm-hmm.
They have no bin that they can throw their stuff. So if you have every day we make trash. We have trash right here. But we can throw it in the bin and then somebody's gonna come take our trash and take it somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
These are all people like living here and stuff and they don't have any way to throw away the garbage, they just throw it. What can they do? Thailand, you can't see something like this, can you?
No.
See nice people, they see me away. Okay, this is...
6,000.
Uh-huh. Oh, I'm sorry, let me rewind that.
Area.
Okay.
Okay, this is
60,000 children.
60,000 children?
Yeah.
And how many children does Children International have in this area? 28,000 under children. Children.
This area is 6,000.
The headquarters on board too has 6,000 kids, but Children International takes care of like 20,000 kids in the area. So. Just looking to see. This is in, you already know. You can tell the people where are we now? Where was I? This is in one of the Children International headquarters.
Human bodies. For the heat.
Yeah, for the dentist. There's just a moment ago arriving to Children International. Do I have? Let me see. I just gotta see something. Okay, so now I know what I'm looking at. Now we're leaving Children International. This was one of the coolest things that ever happened to me. I may have a video of it that I was with these people for so long, speaking and shaking hands and saying goodbye. Like love. All these people, they have a sponsor like me, but they don't get to meet their sponsor. So I think they were looking at me and thinking like, this is like the same kind of person who lets me go to school, lets me have food and all this stuff. So. It was like giving love to each other. Mm-hmm. Very cool.
Yeah, very good.
Felt very good. This is a 40-minute video. Obviously, I can't show that on now. Am knows where we are now because Am's been here before. This is.
She's happy.
Yeah. Atika is my sponsor child. She's my first sponsor child ever. And the lady you just saw,
okay.
One of those ladies was her mom. I'll show you later. And this experience, this day that I'm showing you now, like, was so touching to me. Like, it influenced me to go and sponsor more kids with Children International. Mom's come with me to India, and we visited three of the kids I got over there. I got a bunch across the world that I haven't got to meet yet.
She's the mother of
Atika.
So,
yes.
Maybe now you're going to be able to see a little bit of the room. And
yes.
Mom, dad, and three kids all sleep in this one little room.
They're late, so that is why she sent the child to the center.
Oh, yeah.
I love this lady. That's Atika's mom you're seeing.
She was waiting.
Yeah.
I love this lady.
You're not coming. She's asking.
Is she excited?
She's excited.
They're telling the story now. I arrived to the house and Atika wasn't there because she got so excited to see me that she couldn't wait. So she went and walked to the center.
Same before.
She felt bad that we were late last time. Same. Yeah.
Sure.
Atika should be
around
this week.
Grandma.
That's the grandma. So I'm trying to show now the size of the room. Because, like, brothers and sisters, how do I say it? Like, the parents' family will all live in the same, like, compound. So they'll share, like, a cooking area. But, like, each family has their own bedroom. So this room... Sorry for the bad video. This room has mom, dad, like an 8-year-old boy, 7-year-old girl, and like a 3-year-old kid, who now they're actually much older. This is 5 years ago.
I think when you're filming, some people like to sleep with mom and dad, like together.
So many people together in a small space.
Be careful.
Yeah. Sorry.
She works for Children International.
Send her back. So it'll be a few minutes. She said it's...
So Tika's on her way back to her house now. I don't know who this lady is. This is the little girl. This is Atika's little sister. She looks like a boy there, right?
So young.
This girl who's being held right now is like so cute and like with such a sparkly personality.
Oh, I can't remember she because she's so young.
She doesn't look the same, yeah. Yeah, she looks so different now.
Okay.
I'll show that video another time. I think that's Atika right there. By my mouse.
She's the sister of Atika, but she also wears boys' clothing.
Did you hear the lady? She said, this is the sister of Atika, but she likes to wear boys' clothing. And look at the brother.
She's the youngest.
You recognize his face?
His
face is the same. Mom's such a sweet lady.
Here's
your first game of
the ticket.
Chalo. Right?
Oh.
Chalo.
So it looks like we're...
Where's mommy?
Alright, we're leaving. Every time I go to India, it's almost the same thing. So you already know what we're going to do now.
Go eat, go
buy the kids clothing and presents. Mm. So we just went downstairs from Atika's house and we're in the the SUV now, ready to go shopping. So happy. Yeah, she's tall now. Look at him.
How old can you be once you're 19? So they want to get you young, but then they'll keep you until you're an adult. That's good.
Children international.
If we take the child, maybe 10 to 12 years old, it is of no use because we
go to university or something like that. So, went shopping with Atika. I forget, do I have pictures over here? Here's a picture from her house, and you can now imagine what it's like having, I'm probably the same size as her dad.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody would sleep in this little room. And then we went and ate. Big Bazaar, same exact one we went to. Biryani rice, same like they always get.
Same the pit we eat before.
Same exact place. And I bought toys and clothing for all the kids. And you see all the people from Children International outside. Oh, I remember this girl. I need to see if I can find a video. I'll show you.
What?
Of me talking with everybody here. It's like such a good experience. Okay. I'll go back to the videos, but this was the last picture I took in India before I flew to Thailand. And this was an important picture for me because it says clean drinking water for all today and every day. And like in Europe and American Canada, it's like almost everyone can just drink water. It's not a problem.
Mm-hmm.
People can't even imagine that there's places that it's hard to have clean water.
Mm-hmm.
So that picture was important to me. And I'm about to say goodbye to Atika, it looks like. This was on the way back to the center. Got the ice cream.
No sale.
Yeah, always like do the same. Finish the day with ice cream.
I can feel.
Yeah, like memories.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's about it. Next, I'm gonna fly to Thailand, and can start the next video in Thailand.
Finish when you go in Thailand.
That's finished for India. Still
for China, you finish?
No, I still have to show that.
Oh.
Doing it like first India, then we'll go to Thailand and China. They don't know about China yet.
Oh, before you come in, we go India first and come in Thailand and go China.
China's last.
Oh.
So we'll get to that in a different video. Okie dokie. I think that's the end, unless if I can. This is probably embarrassing.
So today I gotta meet.
Nope, don't want to show that. Alright, goodbye everyone. Unless if I can find the video I want to show you, then I won't cut this.
Wait.
I'm trying to, somewhere on YouTube, I think I have the video from Children International. I don't remember. No, it's not here. What about? What? What?
I know something. Yeah.
Is this all my videos? Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Bye-bye. This is saying goodbye to Atika and at Children International, so I'll quit. Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Guys, what's up, man?
What's up, man?
This is my grandma.
Hi, grandma. Namaste. Ryan.
Nice to meet you.
You too. What's up, guys? Hello, hello. What's up, man? Hey, man, chilling, bro.
Good memories.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, hey. You good?
This guy's so handsome. Look how cool he looks.
Hello, sir.
Hello, how are you?
I am very good. How are you?
Look how cute she is.
Wow, you're so pretty. Hello. Look at the pretty girl in the camera. Oh my gosh.
Welcome, hola, welcome.
Welcome, hello. Very nice to meet you.
Hello, how are you?
Hello, how are you? I'm good, how are you?
What is your name?
Ryan. You?
Farin?
Farin Kato. That's a great name.
Ryan, very nice. What is the name?
Ryan. You?
Lazia.
Lazia? Very nice name. Very pretty name. Oh, yeah.
Chalo.
Bye bye. Chalo. Yeah. Wow. Look at this. Bye bye everybody.
From Disney?
Yeah.
For me she looks like a white person and a black person together.